the Crane Room for your lunch and dinner rendezvous. You'll enjoy their pleasant atmosphere. The Crane Room takes pride in their wide variety menu. Appetizers, sandwiches, soups, salads, entrees, pasta, and the best burgers in town. Newcastle's best selection of domestic, import, and craft beers from around the world. And the Crane Room features a 35-tap draft system. Ask about their daily specials that will please you every time. The Crane Room is located at 3009 Wilmington Road in Neshannock Township. Call 724-656-1553.
Joshua Sun Rehabilitation Center. From the moment you arrive, you know that you're in the right place. Dr. John Wrightson listens first. He pays attention to detail and then makes the determination. Joshua Sun Rehabilitation. We make the pain go away.
Good morning. Yes, welcome. It's Monday, April 6th. We made it through that holiday weekend. And now, let the egg salad sandwiches begin. As you get ready for NewsWatch, hopefully you got that first cup of coffee, because NewsWatch is straight ahead for you.
Everyone goes to Pizza Joe's, and you've heard that friendly slogan for many years, and it's just as true today as it was when you first heard it. Watch the game right here on NCTV 45, and then head over to Pizza Joe's. Pizza Joe's provided a grant for this podcast, and they have many great locations, State Street, Highland Avenue, Croton, and Shenango. It's your local pizza place. Everyone goes to Pizza Joe's. We have a great relationship with Main Street Clothiers and Custom Tailors in downtown Newcastle at 210 East Washington Street. And whenever you watch Focus NC, my wardrobe is furnished by Main Street Clothiers and Custom Tailors.
Magisterial District Judge Melissa A. Amodi announces her candidacy for Judge of the Court of Common Pleas for the 53rd Judicial District. A lifelong resident of Lawrence County with 15 years of judicial experience, Judge Amodi is the only candidate with judicial experience running for this position. Because of her experience, Judge Amodi has a unique understanding of the issues and concerns of families, schools, and businesses throughout our county. Judge Amodi is a proud graduate of Newcastle High School. She attended the University of Pittsburgh, graduating cum laude, and obtained her law degree from Duquesne University School of Law. She passed the bar in Pennsylvania and New Jersey. Judge Amodi respectfully asks for your vote for Judge of the Court of Common Pleas in the May 2015 primary election. She hopes to be a candidate on the Republican and Democratic ticket. The only judge running for judge, paid for by the committee to elect Amodi for judge.
Don't lie around like the winter snow.
Bringing the NCTV 45.
Welcome to Monday, April 6th. Hopefully you got that first cup of coffee as we get to the top stories today in Newcastle, PA. Now, Friday I had the opportunity to go to the Good Friday breakfast at the Y. Hats off to the Y, the staff, and everybody involved. What an excellent time and an excellent breakfast. The guest speaker was Reverend David Young Sr., and it was a very enjoyable, inspirational speech. As you can see, we're going to get to some of that as you watch. Now, mark your day, speaking of the Y, for a calendar of community fun. It's Party in the Park for Justice. That's the Women's Crisis Shelter of Lawrence County. It just says Crisis Shelter. It's at the Riverwalk downtown from 1 to 4. There's a bounce house, popcorn games, smokehouse, cotton candy, face painting, music. Just a really good time. If you have for some free time on that Saturday afternoon from 1 to 4, stop down, bring the kids. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. In the morning, if you're looking to do a little bit of volunteer work, they can use you over there at the United Way. Their office is 223 North Mercer Street. And they're going to have a cleanup day now from 8 to 12, breakfast and registration, outside landscaping and cleaning, washing walls, painting bathrooms, washing woodwork, cleaning out the attic, and lunch will be provided. The United Way will receive $200 in materials per person for a breakfast lunch, and Comcast will donate $6 per person towards the United Way campaign. Now, after you do those two things, if you have some time on that Saturday, well, from 4 to 7, you can go to the annual fundraiser for Lawrence County and the Children's Summer Program. It's called Empty Bowls. Now, during the course of the year, a lot of free lunches are provided at the various schools. During the summer, those children have nothing to eat. With a $10 donation, you're going to get soup, bread, cookies, and a homemade bowl. It's from 4 to 7 at the First Baptist Church, 984 West Maitland Lane. Now, Wednesday's right around the corner, and the United Way has their dinner. It's their 91st annual meeting and volunteer recognition dinner. It's at the Villa. That's 2500 New Butler Road. Reception at 5 and dinner 5:45. The cost is $35. Contact the United Way for more information. Now, the Lawrence County Historical Society has an interesting program going on Wednesday, April 8th at 7. It's called From the Historical Society to the National Archives. And we covered this better than I could cover it in community happenings. And Gary West spoke of it highly. Please check it out. It's very informative and will give you a lot of information for those people who like history. Now, keep in mind that, and I know I talk about them a lot, but they're really trying to make Newcastle and Lawrence County a better place. The volunteer group New Visions, a grassroots movement, is planning on cleaning up the Neshannock Creek Trail from the bottom of Croton Avenue out to the Paper Mill Bridge. Now, this cleanup's going to take place on April 11th, and you should dress appropriately. Contact Larry Corvey for more information. What they're probably going to be doing is cleaning brush from the trail to make it passable. Also keep in mind that it's rain or shine. So that being said, plan to be there and help them do a great job. Also, they have different action teams, and their communications action team will be meeting on April 7th at 6 at the Confluence. Please make some time in your busy schedule to stop by. Now, this in to members of the Downtown Business Association. In our continuing efforts to help everyone better understand the understanding of the employers located in downtown, we welcome North American Dental Group, Refresh Dental, CEO Ken Cooper, as our guest speaker. Okay. And this is going to be, I believe, on April 23rd, as they continue on. Also presenting County Public Safety with Brian Melser. Okay. Matt Staniszewski from the city will talk about the blueprint. Larry Corvey about new visions and the cleanup. The April 23rd New Visions meeting and the results of the New Visions meeting. Janet Filotico with Travel and Tourism. And this is see you on April 7th, okay, for that meeting. So that's tomorrow that they're planning on having quite a bit for the Downtown Business Association meeting. Something you should keep in mind, great group of people there. Hats off to them. In from the state, Banking and Securities Department announces quarterly report and enforcement orders. The Department of Banking and Securities issued 9 enforcement orders during the first quarter of 2015. The final orders include fines and assessments for $221,875. You can check that out by going to the state website. Construction to begin on the Poe Patty Tunnel along Penns Creek. Anglers, hikers, and other enthusiasts are reminded that repair work will soon be started. Now barricaded, the Poe Patty Creek Tunnel along Penn Creek in a wide range of rehabilitation projects. So it's temporarily closed, this section of the Mid-State Trail, and it's going to start being closed today. So I don't know if we have anybody going in that direction, but if you were, you might want to keep that in mind. Tom Wolf has no scheduled appearances, okay, over the last few days, so he's taking a break to enjoy the Easter holiday himself. Now, we're going to be back with sports and weather right after these messages. The Beanery Depot and Deli. Coffee, made-to-order subs, snacks, and more. Meatball sandwiches, fresh and hot. Pepperoni rolls, fish sandwiches, chicken, milkshakes. The Beanery Deli. When you're hungry for something special, and it won't cost you a lot of beans.
Let's talk with Norm.
We're with
Norm Lutton.
Norm, you're the owner of Crazy Car Restoration. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, it's a new company we're opening up. Originally, we was Lutton Auto Repair, and we're adding on a little bit. And we're trying to bring out some custom cars for people somewhere in between the $5,000 and $20,000 range, what people can actually afford today. Anymore, you know, all these cars are so expensive, we're just trying to make ends meet for other people.
That sounds great now.
But I've been fixing cars for over 35 years.
That's great.
So when you have a repair, big or small, call Norm.
Welcome back. And now it's time for sports, but before we get to that, and we're going to lead right into this, a little note. I had the opportunity to visit Augustine's Pizza in their new location. And yes, as you already may have guessed, they're pounding out those pizzas, the little ones now, for fundraisers and various games and organizations. Now, here are just a few pictures showing everybody hard at work. They're waiting for the bigger press so that they can make the bigger style pizzas. Now, speaking of Augustine's Pizza, and we all know Frank's a big Pirate fan, the Pirates dropped one to the Philadelphia Phillies in spring training. And they will be in action today down in Cincinnati taking on the Reds. Now, the Cleveland Indians didn't fare well either against the Milwaukee Brewers. And they're going to be in Houston to take on the Astros. Turning our heads to basketball, tonight's Final Four matchup will pit Duke against the Wisconsin Badgers. And in the NBA, Sunday, Cleveland outlasted the Chicago Bulls 99-94. While Philadelphia came in to play hockey against the Pens, and that didn't go so hot for the Pens, dropping the game 4-1. Now, that kind of puts the Pens in a little precarious position as the playoffs come right around the corner. Well, I hope you're in a great position with your coffee and relaxing on this Monday morning, because we're going to be back with weather right after these messages.
They look like you should be able to find them in a lot of the bigger, more expensive department stores.
Our scarves, our shrugs, and our Say No More shirts are exclusive to Inspire Tees. We want to give you apparel that is pretty, sexy, flirty, and makes you look like the woman you are meant to be.
Hi friends, I'm Gary West, and whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store or at their restaurant in Newcastle, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Welcome back, and now it's time to take a look at that Newcastle, Lawrence County weather forecast. Well, last night saw a partly cloudy low of 39 with winds blowing from the south at 5 miles an hour. Today, there's a slight chance of showers, but after 3, it's partly sunny with a high near 60, a southwest wind 5 to 10 miles an hour, and the chance of precipitation is 20%. Now, Monday night, a slight chance of showers, mainly after 8, cloudy with a low around 49, South wind will blow at 6 miles an hour. The chance of precipitation 30%. And new precipitation amounts less than a tenth of an inch. Tuesday, showers and thunderstorms likely. You're going to want to take along that umbrella. A high of 64. Again, the south wind at 5 to 9 miles an hour. The chance of precipitation 50%. And Tuesday night, showers likely, possibly thunderstorms before 10. Okay, the chance of showers and thunderstorms are 50%. Check that, 60%. And they'll be before 10 and then between 10 and 2. Okay, and the low will be 50 degrees. So it looks like a rainy start to your work week, as looking ahead, Wednesday has some of those same showers and thunderstorms also. Now, we're going to be back with a wrap-up right after these messages.
The China Banquet in Newcastle for a tempting, mouth-watering buffet that you'll enjoy every time. China Banquet is open Sunday through Thursday, 11 a.m. to 9:30 p.m. and Friday and Saturday, 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Call for takeout or eat in their pleasant surroundings. China Banquet is located at 102 North Jefferson Street in Newcastle. Call 724-658-7777. That's 724-658-7777.
The Globe Leader, your hometown newspaper since 1880. Go to nwglobe.com to read fascinating articles. If you know someone who would enjoy this amazing publication as much as you do, why not give them a gift subscription? I'm excited about getting this into the homes of as many people as possible. Please send their email address and we'll do the rest. Call 724-946-8098. That's the Globe Leader, your hometown newspaper since 1880.
Don't lie around like the winter snow.
Bring in the NCTV 45.
Welcome back. That's going to do it for this Monday, April 6th. Enjoy that sunshine because, you know, we're going to be in store for a little bit of rain. That April showers brings May flowers, but let's hope it gets out of here kind of quick. Meanwhile, you make sure that you get that second cup of coffee and keep watching NCTV 45. Where we're available anytime on your time. I want to make sure you have the best possible Monday you could have as we start back to work or enjoy that last day of vacation if you're in school. So get that second cup of coffee. Have a great Monday, everybody, and we'll see you first thing Tuesday morning.